Climate Change, Aha. January 9, 2020 by Anna von Reitz. Oh, it's about change, all right. The kind you carry in your pocket. Let's begin with the fact that I do not believe in human-caused climate change, unless you are talking about the kind that military contractors cause when they fool around with manipulating the jet streams and dumping noxious chemical compounds on us and setting up resonance weapons to destabilize earthquake faults and stimulate volcanic eruptions and air pollution and, well, the list goes on. That kind of human-caused climate change has been going on since the 1960s and is the reason that we have United Nations Environmental Modification, Geoengineering, and Weather Warfare Treaties. I believe in that kind of climate change, and no doubt about it. However, some people reading this were too young to remember that weather warfare manipulation of the monsoons was a major hot topic during the conflict in Vietnam. It turned out that our boys in green were not only theoretically able to interfere with the monsoons and the jet streams, but were actually doing so. That's what provoked the whole cockroach-like swarm and then scatter activity associated with these treaties. Not only were they rapidly proposed and rapidly adopted, it all happened very quietly, so that the mainstream news sources could continue to pretend that weather modification was just another conspiracy theory. Think about it. It's a theory about a conspiracy that is actual, factual, and proven. A conspiracy that is ancient and venal, having first taken its modern form during the reign of the Roman Emperor Justinian. And it's okay to be a theory in scientific terms, for while nothing is ever proven, the vast preponderance and weight of the evidence and the test results do strongly suggest that our climate change is being rigged and orchestrated and that the motive is profit and oppressive political control. Having once achieved the ability and technical know-how to dabble in adjusting the weather, the crackpots weaponized it, and now you can see what you've got going: environmental disasters by the busloads delivered by what appears to be our own governments. So, their gig with the IRS and the income tax has been exposed as fraud, and their illegal, immoral, and unlawful system of pledging and bonding and securitizing living people has been exposed, so now they just have to come up with something, some way, to tax and control people again. Using weather warfare and geoengineering technology that they have been developing ever since the 1960s, they've been planning all sorts of death and destruction and demonstrations of their technology, all without telling their domestic populations a word about it. Sound familiar? Just like they pledged you behind your back to do everything short of wiping their butts for them, they have been carrying out tests of their weather warfare and geoengineering technology on subject domestic populations without a word to the victims, then using the horrible results of these tests as an excuse to ramp up their carbon tax scheme, which is really what all this is about. Taxes. Regulations giving rise to taxes, fees, fines, and confiscations, otherwise known as illegal takings. Just a new excuse for the same old shtick. Money and control gained by, 1, causing a big problem, and, 2, offering a solution to the problem they caused, and, 3, implementing their solution, which always predictably involves more money and more coercive power for them. Standard Hegelian, Machiavellian, Orwellian BS, the kind that attempts to prove that some pigs really are more equal than others. Diapers on cows, anyone? Earthquakes on both sides of the North American continent at once? Panicked, stupid, wild-eyed teenagers and sobbing housewives? Climate change symptoms that they control are not the topics of their discussions, why should they be? Carbon taxes and carbon emission regulations giving rise to the new taxes are the goal. They want a new excuse to tax you and regulate your activities, since the old excuses are going down to dust. Pure and simple. And you can't afford to let them get away with it. Literally. We have to expose and prosecute these monsters, or they will use ginned-up climate change and engineered natural disasters to enforce a whole new regimen of taxation, regulation, and terror onto ourselves and our children's children. This whole ugly system of diabolical lies and information manipulations being used as the means to profit and control has to end, and all those involved need to go get honest jobs instead. Not only is my disbelief in climate change rooted in a good understanding of how current weather warfare and geoengineering technology can be used to secretively fake and exacerbate the appearance of climate change, and then used as an excuse to promote oppressive regulations and carbon taxes, I also happen to be familiar with the calcium-carbon cycle. above any beyond all other reasons why you and I can be absolutely sure that our innocent activities like breathing and cows farting has no ill effect upon the earth or its climate, stands the calcium-carbon cycle, the process by which extra carbon dioxide is captured and turned into calcium carbonate. It's a completely natural cycle built into the chemistry and biology of the earth, that cashiers away extra carbon dioxide as soft rock minerals that are difficult to degrade by any natural process. Thus, unlike greenbelt carbon capture, which only stores the excess carbon as long as the trees are alive and growing, the calcium carbonate cycle is a relatively permanent storehouse for extra carbon dioxide. Best of all, it costs nothing, is universally at work and available, efficient, and more than sufficient to sop up any extra carbon dioxide that we or our activities create. For free. So these blackguard already know that they are telling you all a great big fat one, and that all the hysteria they are causing, deliberately, is nothing but another theatrical production and sting operation with which they hope to secure another long run as the comptrollers and beneficiaries of this planet. You have a direct benefit of your own to realize by turning on your Shinola sensor, leaving it on high, and despite all their tricks, bells, and whistles, staying on track and investigating them and prosecuting them as the criminals and con artists they are. Links to this article and more can be found in the video description box.